Welcome to the Reality Revolution. I'm your host, Brian Scott. Today, I'm going to show you how to create your reality. Now, I've talked about this in literally every episode of my podcast, but I realized when somebody asked me, where should I start? I didn't really have an episode that's just dedicated to how to create your reality, written by me, that sort of takes all the teachings that we've had and puts them together. I would first check out my episode, Your Thoughts Create Reality, so that you can at least have a base established that proves or verifies, confirms the idea that your thoughts create reality. I do not want to spend a bunch of time in this episode explaining that thoughts create reality. We know that thoughts create reality. Taking that as a given, let me give you the steps and techniques and ways for you to create your reality. After you watch this episode, the thin veil between your thought and reality will dissolve, and your deepest yearnings will crystallize before your very eyes, and the universe will intricately mold itself to the whispers of your heart's intent. This is not just any other episode. Consider this to be a gateway to a new existence for you, where the unthinkable becomes achievable and the figments of your imagination will solidify. This is an invitation for you to interact with the quantum threads of existence, to reshape the melody of your life's narrative at will. Here you're going to uncover the secrets of transforming ephemeral thoughts into palpable realities, where inner monologues become the incantations that summon your desires, where gratitude opens the floodgates to prosperity, and where the heart and mind converge in a harmonious act of creation. You'll navigate through the tempests of resistance, steering by the stars of your intentions and anchoring in the realms of your aspirations. But heed this warning. This exploration demands bravery to trust in the invisible, the resolve to redefine the contours of your life, and the insight to recognize yourself as the sculptor of your destiny. I'm not saying your road will be devoid of hurdles. I'm trying to equip you with the instruments to construct pathways over them, to transform barriers into gateways, and to perceive obstacles as chances to evolve. This is an enthralling experience. When you learn how to create your own reality, it changes everything. You learn that you are the main actor in your story, where you are both the creator and the protagonist, scripting epic tales of achievement, affection, vitality, and wealth. Are you prepared to unlock the power that lies within you? To shed the confines of doubt and ascend the true possibilities of your life. This is the art and science of shaping your existence. You might have seen the movie The Secret and the thousands and thousands of videos that you can find on YouTube of people talking about how to create your reality. So I want to put all this in one place, because over time, over 2,000 episodes, we have evolved in learning different techniques that are very effective. I've coached a number of people, and in my own life, I've been able to create the reality that I dreamed of. The essence of creating a reality is not a secret kept in the shadows, but a truth as old as time, waiting to be rediscovered and wielded with intention and precision. You stand on the threshold of a new understanding, where the lines between the seen and the unseen start to blur, and where your inner world becomes the architect of your outer experience. You hold the pen that writes the chapters of your future. With each word I give you, you will begin to uncover the principles that allow you to align with the frequencies of abundance, well-being, and fulfillment. You'll learn how to clear the static of doubt, fear, and limiting beliefs, and turn into the clear signal of your true desires. The fabric of reality. At the heart of your experience lies a profound and often overlooked truth. Reality is not a rigid, unchanging structure. It is fluid, shaped and reshaped by the currents of your perceptions, beliefs, and thoughts. So let's explore the malleable nature of reality and how your inner world molds your outer experiences, drawing on the insights of quantum field theory and the transformative power of your subconscious mind. Consider for a moment the idea that what we perceive as solid, unchangeable reality is in fact a canvas upon which our thoughts and beliefs paint the scenery. This is not mere metaphor, but a reflection of a deeper truth about the nature of existence. Every moment, every experience is a manifestation of a collective and individual consciousness, a symphony of thought energy taking form. Quantum field theory offers a glimpse into the scientific underpinnings of how thoughts influence reality. At the quantum level, particles do not have fixed states until they are observed. This fundamental aspect of quantum mechanics suggests that at a very basic level, the act of observation, and by extension, the observer's expectations, thoughts, and beliefs can influence the outcome of physical events. This interplay between consciousness and the physical world invites us to reconsider our role in shaping our reality. It implies that our perceptions and beliefs are not merely reactions to the world around us, but are active contributors to its creation. The implications are profound. By changing our internal state, we can alter our external world. The teachings of Neville Goddard and Joseph Murphy offer invaluable insights into harnessing this potential. Goddard's law of assumption posits that assuming the feeling of your wish as fulfilled already sets into motion the events necessary for its materialization. Murphy, on the other hand, emphasizes the subconscious mind's role in shaping our reality. He suggests that by impressing our subconscious with our desires through repetition and emotional engagement, we can create a blueprint for our reality to follow. Both teachings highlight the incredible power of the mind to influence reality. The subconscious mind operates beyond the constraints of logic and time, working tirelessly to align our external circumstances with our internal states. By understanding and applying these principles, we can begin to consciously influence the fabric of our reality. To apply these concepts, start by observing your thoughts and beliefs. This is the most important step. Notice how they correlate with your experiences. Experiment with intentionally shifting your thoughts towards the outcomes you desire. Practice assuming the feeling of your wish fulfilled. Neville Goddard taught the feeling as being the key aspect, not as a distant dream, but as your present reality. Impress upon your subconscious the vision of your life as you wish it to be through visualization, affirmations, and emotional engagement. This is a moment-by-moment process, breath-by-breath, second-by-second. By understanding the malleable nature of existence and the role of your thoughts and beliefs in shaping it, you can open yourself to the limitless possibilities of what you can create. The fabric of reality is woven from the threads of your perceptions, beliefs, and thoughts, and by mastering these elements, you have begun the first step into creating your reality. The power of belief. The landscape of your reality is sculpted by the beliefs you hold, serving as the foundation upon which your experiences are built. Beliefs are not just passive notions that reside in the back of your mind. They are active forces shaping your perceptions, reactions, and the very essence of your being. Joseph Murphy's exploration of the subconscious mind provides a pivotal framework for understanding how deeply ingrained beliefs influence your reality. The subconscious mind is likened to a vast, fertile garden where the beliefs you plant determine the nature of the crop you harvest. Just as a garden requires attention and care to yield desirable produce, your subconscious mind needs nurturing with positive, empowering beliefs to create a reality that reflects your true desires and aspirations. The first step in transforming your reality is to identify the limiting beliefs that have taken root in your subconscious. These beliefs may have been sown in childhood through societal conditioning or past experiences, and they act as barriers to your growth and fulfillment. To identify these beliefs, you must become an observer of your thoughts, emotions, and reactions, tracing them back to the underlying assumptions about yourself and the world around you. So begin by reflective journaling. Engage in reflective journaling and asking yourself probing questions about your fears, doubts, and the areas of your life where you feel stuck. Look for the pattern that suggests underlying beliefs. Why am I fearful about this? Why am I acting in this way? By asking questions and then simply journaling about it, you begin the process of beginning to understand where your beliefs lie. The truth is, you may not even know what you truly believe. The second step is to practice meditation and mindfulness to become aware of your thought patterns and emotional response. Yes, you can do and use meditation to create your reality, but before you do that, this step is important. You must create a heightened awareness that will reveal your beliefs that shape these internal experiences. Once you've identified your limiting beliefs, the work of transformation begins. Changing deeply ingrained beliefs requires intention, persistence, and a variety of strategies tailored to reprogram the subconscious mind. First of all, you can use affirmations. Constructing positive affirmations that directly counteract your limiting beliefs. Repeat these affirmations daily, ideally during moments of quiet reflection or meditation, to embed them in your subconscious. I like to use them in the morning and at night before I go to bed, maybe in the middle of the day. After using affirmations, you want to employ visualization techniques to imagine yourself living the reality that your new empowering beliefs support. Visualization engages the subconscious mind by creating vivid emotional experiences that reinforce your desired beliefs. The construction of new empowering beliefs is an act of creation. It involves deliberately choosing beliefs that align with your goals and desires, then embedding these beliefs into your subconscious mind to influence your reality positively. Neville Goddard liked to refer to all of us as gods, with the power of God, except one limitation. That is our belief. So you understand what you believe, and then you go about the process of changing it. Then, how do you build new empowering beliefs after you've done this? You can begin by scripting your beliefs. Check out my episode on scripting to create your reality. Write down your new beliefs in a detailed, affirmative manner. The new beliefs that you want to take on. Maybe you don't necessarily believe that you're successful or that you're prosperous, so you write them down in a detailed, affirmative manner. Describe how these beliefs influence your behavior, emotions, and the world around you. This exercise makes your new beliefs tangible and actionable. If you have the thought that you can't change your beliefs, just look around the world. People's beliefs are being changed all the time. The next step is to gather evidence. Actively seek out and document evidence that supports your new beliefs. The mind is amazing, and it will find what you look for. This practice will reinforce the validity of your beliefs and gradually shift your perceptions to align with your desired reality. There are some exercises for building empowering beliefs. First, try a belief assessment exercise. Make a list of your core beliefs about yourself, others, and the world. And next to each belief, write down how it has shaped your experiences. Evaluate which beliefs serve you and which do not. Secondly, the belief bridge technique. For each limiting belief, create a bridge belief that is more positive and feels attainable. For example, if your limiting belief is, I'm not good enough to succeed, a bridge belief might be, I'm open to seeing my inherent value and potential. Use these bridge beliefs as stepping stones to more empowering beliefs. And third, daily belief integration. Choose one empowering belief to focus on each day. And throughout the day, ask yourself how someone with that belief would act, think, and feel, and align your actions and your mindset with this belief to integrate it into your reality. I'm dedicating the beginning of this to beliefs because as I've taught reality creation for a long time, I have found that the beliefs that you have are absolutely key. And by consciously cultivating a garden of empowering beliefs, you will open yourself to a reality that reflects your highest potential. The power of belief is the key to unlocking a life of abundance, growth, and fulfillment. The art of assuming. At the heart of transforming your reality lies a powerful, yet often overlooked principle, the art of assuming, the feeling of the wish fulfilled. This principle, championed by Neville Goddard, teaches us that to manifest your desire, you must first inhabit the emotional state and conviction that your desires have already been realized. It's not merely about wanting or hoping. It's about embodying the certainty and feeling of the desired outcome as a present reality, not something in the future. To live in the end means to operate from a state of being, where your desire is not a distant dream, but a present fact of your life. This involves a shift from longing to being, from desiring to having. It's a mental and emotional alignment with your desired reality, where you assume the feelings and attitudes of one who has already achieved your goal. Begin by creating a vivid mental scene. Identify a scene that implies the fulfillment of your desire. This scene should be brief, specific, and charged with emotional significance. It might be a moment of celebration, a conversation indicating success, or a simple action that signifies the achievement of your goal. For instance, if you wanted to win a gold medal in the Olympics, you might imagine yourself biting down on that gold medal or standing up and celebrating your victory. Then, the next step is emotional saturation. You immerse yourself in this mental scene until it feels so vivid and real. The goal is to saturate your consciousness with the emotions and sensory experiences of this reality, such as joy, gratitude, or peace. Many people struggle with this because they have not actually inhabited that reality. So your mind must go through a process of imagining and making believe. You can ask yourself the question, how would I feel if? By beginning that process, you can do this. For many, it takes time, but continue to work on immersing yourself in the mental scene until it feels so vivid and real that you cannot distinguish it from reality. You should enjoy this process. It's daydreaming, amplified and magnified. Emotional resonance is the vibrational match between your emotional state and the frequency of your desired reality. It acts as a magnetic force, attracting experiences that resonate with your inner state. And to manifest your desires, to create your reality, your emotions must align with the feeling of already having or being what you wish for. The feeling is the secret. Embody the feeling of your wish fulfilled throughout your day, not just during moments of visualization or for a brief 10-minute meditation. To truly create your reality, this is a continuous process. Continuous emotional alignment signals to the universe that you are ready to receive your desire. Then, you must cultivate a positive emotional state. You can do this by practicing gratitude, love, and appreciation daily. These are the emotions that you would feel if your wish was fulfilled. These emotions have high vibrational frequencies that enhance your manifestation abilities. Always be in a state of gratitude, love, and appreciation. Imagination is the canvas upon which you paint your desired reality, and visualization is the brush you use to bring these visions to life. And through imaginative practice, you create a blueprint of your desired reality, which the subconscious mind works to realize in the physical world. Regular visualization practice is key. Dedicate time each day to visualize your desired outcome using the scene you've constructed. The more regularly you practice, the more real and attainable your desire feels. Generally, I have people that will go into the comments and say that I'm incapable of visualizing. First of all, remove that belief. I've had people that said they have never been able to visualize that have been able to visualize, but try some alternative. Painting a picture, writing it out in a script, finding a way to imagine the scene in some way, shape, and form. There may be an alternative way for you to visualize. Do not abandon the idea that you can visualize. Then next, you want to have sensory richness. Incorporate all five senses into your visualization. This is important. Oftentimes people will only see what they're trying to visualize, but each of these senses are gates that expand on your power and ability and also directly affect the subconscious in the ways that you need for the reality to be created. What do you see, hear, feel, taste, and smell in your realized desire? The more detailed and sensory rich your visualization, the more powerful its impact on your subconscious mind. To weave the art of assuming into the fabric of your daily life, it's essential to maintain a consistent practice of living in the end. Emotional resonance and imaginative visualization. Here are practical steps to integrate this art into your everyday experience. 1. Morning intention setting. Start each day by setting an intention to embody the feeling of your wish fulfilled. Visualize your desired scene and immerse yourself in its emotional state. 2. Emotional alignment checks. Throughout the day, periodically check in with your emotional state. Are you maintaining the feeling of your wish fulfilled? Use breath work or quick visualizations to realign if necessary. And 3, evening reflection. Reflect on your day. Focus on the moments where you successfully maintained your desired emotional state. This is an ongoing process. You have to continue to do it. Visualize your desired scene again before sleep to reinforce it in your subconscious. By mastering the art of assuming, you harness the creative power of your emotions and imagination to manifest the reality that you desire. This practice transforms the abstract into the tangible, guiding the unseen forces of the universe to shape your world according to your deepest aspirations. Reality transurfing. Reality transurfing, a powerful conceptual framework for understanding and navigating the complexities of creating your reality, offers a unique perspective on the mechanics of manifestation. It transcends traditional manifestation concepts that we've discussed so far and introduces a set of principles that empower individuals to consciously choose their paths in life. I want to discuss the core principles of transurfing to elucidate how you can apply them to manifest your desired reality by aligning with the optimal life tracks available in the space of variations. Reality transurfing is based on the premise that reality is multi-layered, consisting of an infinite number of possibilities or variations. This multitude of potential realities exists within a quantum field known as the space of variations. And according to transurfing, our consciousness interacts with this field, selecting the reality we experience through our thoughts, emotions, and intentions. This perspective shifts the focus from trying to change the external world to choosing our path within it. The key concepts of reality transurfing are, first, the space of variations. This is the quantum field that contains all possible outcomes, events, and paths that one's life can take. It's a vast information space of potential realities where every possible variation of your life already exists. Secondly, is pendulums. These are energetic structures formed by the collective thoughts and emotions of individuals. If everybody is creating their reality and everybody's thoughts are influencing reality, what happens when groups of people, collective thoughts, start to create reality? That's when you get pendulums, and they can sway people's thoughts and emotions, and they are swaying your thoughts and emotions, trapping you in an unwanted reality. Recognizing and detaching from these outside forces, these pendulums, is crucial for maintaining control over your personal reality. And the third concept is energy levels. Your personal energy level determines your ability to navigate the space of variations. Higher energy levels enhance your capacity to choose and stabilize the desired reality. Managing your energy wisely is the key to successful transurfing. Reality transurfing offers strategic approaches to consciously choose and navigate toward your preferred life tracks within the space of variations. First of all, reducing importance. One of the central tenets of transurfing is the reduction of excessive importance placed on goals, outcomes, or challenges. By neutralizing the energy of importance, you avoid creating excess potential that can lead you away from your desired reality. If you want to exist within a certain reality and you put a lot of importance into it, you will never get the change in reality that you desire. By reducing the importance, you take away thoughts of want and desire that always push the reality away from you. Now, the second strategy for navigating reality through transurfing is sliding to the desired reality. This involves shifting your focus and energy towards the reality you wish to inhabit by visualizing and embodying the emotions and state of being associated with that reality. This shift enables you to slide into the desired life track within the space of variations. The third strategy is energy management. Cultivating and preserving your energy is essential for effective transurfing. Practices such as meditation, mindfulness, and pursuing activities that align with your heart's desire help maintain high energy levels, facilitating easier navigation through the space of variations. Things like pendulums can affect your energy and take it away from you. So when you understand your energy, you become emboldened and empowered to create your reality very efficiently. There are practical applications to the transurfing teachings. To apply these principles, consider the following practical steps. First, awareness of pendulums. Become aware of the pendulums that influence your thoughts and emotions. Things like corporations and political parties, mass media, events that happen, anything that's incorporating a large group of people and their thoughts will begin to affect your reality. And by detaching and refusing to give your energy to these pendulums, you gain the freedom to choose your reality. And secondly, balancing importance. Identify areas of your life where you've assigned excessive importance. Work on balancing this by seeing your goals and challenges from a perspective of calm detachment, reducing the emotional charge and potential obstacles. And third, the visualization and slide technique. Regularly practice visualizing your desired reality as a vivid scene, including the emotions and sensations associated with it, as I mentioned earlier. This creates a slide that helps you align with the corresponding life track in the space of variations. By integrating transurfing principles into your approach to manifesting your reality, you unlock a powerful method for navigating the myriad possibilities of life, guiding you toward your desired reality with precision and ease. And I mentioned transurfing in my episode on how to create your reality because it was a very profound realization for me that allowed me to create my reality. Understanding the concepts of the law of assumption and the subconscious mind were important, but understanding reality transurfing helped me take it to the next level. Transurfing is like a software that you can use that allows you to effectively create your reality and avoid the obstacles that people normally encounter along the way. Emotional guidance system. Our emotions serve as a sophisticated guidance system, offering real-time feedback about our alignment with our desired reality or the presence of resistance. Emotions are much more than reactions to external stimuli. They are indicators of your vibrational alignment with the universe. Positive emotions such as joy and love and gratitude signal alignment with your desires, showing that your thoughts and beliefs are in harmony with your goals. Conversely, negative emotions like fear, doubt, and anger indicate resistance, highlighting areas where your thoughts and beliefs may be misaligned with your aspirations. Elevating your emotional state is essential for aligning with your desired reality. There's many techniques that you can use to shift your emotions towards a more positive spectrum. Use mindful breathing exercises to center yourself and calm emotional turbulence. Regular meditation combined with visualization of your desired outcomes will significantly improve your emotional well-being. Engage in activities that naturally elevate your mood, such as exercise, spending time in nature, or practicing a hobby. These activities can provide a quick, effective emotional boost. The idea that feeling is the secret to manifestation emphasizes the importance of not just thinking about your desires, but feeling them as if they are already your reality. This principle suggests that the emotional energy you emit is what attracts corresponding experiences into your life. Thus, embodying the feelings associated with your desires is key to bringing them to fruition. Cultivate the emotions you would feel if your desires were already manifested. If you seek abundance, feel abundant. If you desire love, feel love for yourself and others. This alignment attracts experiences that resonate with those feelings. It works every time, and it's working with your heart. And it's why it can be difficult to manifest, because for many of us, emotions are hard to understand. Gratitude can powerfully elevate your emotional state if you are struggling with changing your emotions. Regularly express gratitude for what you have, as well as for the fulfillment of your desires in advance. It's helpful to conduct daily emotional check-ins to assess your emotional state and identify negative emotions that might be pulling you away from what you're trying to manifest. Creating coherence between heart and mind. The alignment of heart and mind is a pivotal aspect of reality creation and offers a pathway to a more integrated and powerful approach to creating your desired reality. By achieving a state of coherence and harmony between your desires, which is your heart, and your beliefs, your mind, we unlock a potent force for attracting your goals. Through specific techniques and exercises, you can cultivate this vital alignment and enhance your ability to manifest your desires with greater ease and efficiency. Heart-brain coherence refers to a state where the psychological and physiological systems operate in harmony, driven by the synchronization between the heart's rhythmic patterns and the brain's neural networks. Research by institutions like the HeartMath Institute has demonstrated that achieving coherence can lead to improved emotional states, increased resilience, and enhanced cognitive functions. In the context of manifestation, coherence amplifies your capacity to align your feelings and thoughts with your intentions, thereby increasing the effectiveness of your manifestation efforts. Creating coherence between the heart and mind involves fostering a positive emotional state that aligns with your mental intentions. This alignment generates a unified field of energy that can significantly impact your ability to attract what you desire. There are techniques to facilitate this coherence. First, focused heart breathing. Concentrate on your heart area and imagine breathing through the heart. This practice helps to shift your focus and energy from the mind to the heart and promotes a state of calmness and balance. When it comes to heart coherence, I always recommend that you listen to Kyle Boyd and Leah Rush, who I interview on the channel, who are experts in heart coherence. Another technique that you can do with focused heart breathing is to combine it with cultivating genuine positive emotions such as love or appreciation or compassion. Focusing on these emotions can enhance the heart's coherence and its synchronization with the brain, creating a powerful state that is conducive to manifestation. Generally, we cannot manifest if it's just with our minds. The heart is where the energy and power comes. So if you really, really want that car and you're doing it from your mind, you're not able to manifest that car. But if you can find it in your heart to want that car. And transurfing describes the differences between heart and mind in that the heart doesn't know or care about numbers. So if you ask for 2,752,000, you're never going to be able to do that because you're only trying to manifest from the mind in that particular number. But if you understand the heart, which is aligned with feelings, which is why this is consistent with the feeling is the secret, and you know the feeling of that number, that is when you find that sweet spot in which reality creation occurs. So a heart-centered meditation exists like this. It's very easy. Find a quiet space, place your hand over your heart to help focus your attention on your heart area. Breathe slowly and deeply, imagining your breath flowing in and out of your heart. Slow down your breath, breathing in and out at the same amount of time, which balances your sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. And as you breathe, you generate feelings of gratitude, love, or joy. Imagine these emotions radiating from your heart and enveloping your entire being. You do this for 5 to 10 minutes, maintaining the focus on heart-generated positive emotions. Boom, it's that easy. Once you begin to integrate heart-brain coherence into your daily life, you will notice that you can transform your approach to reality creation. Your reality will be created faster and easier and more efficiently. By regularly engaging in these practices, you unlock a powerful synergy that can significantly accelerate the reality creation process. Overcoming resistance and navigating challenges. Manifesting your desired reality often involves navigating through resistance and overcoming challenges that arise along the path. That's why I wanted to mention this briefly. Resistance can manifest in various forms, including fear and doubt, procrastination, and external obstacles. It often signals a misalignment between your desires and your current vibrational state or belief system. Recognizing resistance is a critical step towards overcoming it, allowing you to realign with your intentions. There are numerous strategies to overcome resistance. First of all, identify pendulums. Pendulums create resistance by pulling us into negative or unwanted energetic patterns. Recognizing when you're caught in a pendulum sway and consciously choose to detach from it. Next, you can reduce importance. The reduction in importance decreases the energy feeding the resistance, making it easier to navigate through the challenge. Additionally, energy redistribution. Shift your focus and energy away from resistance and towards actions and thoughts that align with your desired reality. This will help in breaking free from the grip of negative pendulums and reduce the impact of obstacles. There are a number of methods to deal with when you face a setback, which is part of the process. Change your perspective on setbacks, viewing them as opportunities for growth and learning. This shift in perspective can transform challenges into stepping stones towards your goals. Treat setbacks as working to your advantage. Sometimes things happen along the way that feel like you're moving backwards when actually you're moving forwards. My favorite example of this is that you get a flat tire on the way to work. This feels like you're encountering some sort of setback, but that flat tire allows you to meet someone at the store that allows you to achieve your goal or saves you from a terrible accident that would have impeded your ability to achieve your reality. So assume that everything is working to your advantage and then stay flexible. Being rigid in your approach will always amplify resistance. Stay open and flexible to alternative paths and solutions that arise, aligning more closely to the flow of life. Detachment and surrender are not about giving up on your desire, but about releasing the tight grip of control and allowing the universe to orchestrate the best outcome. practical steps to create your reality. So if you're someone that wants to have the exact steps to create reality, then let's look at it this way. First, define your desire clearly. Start by clearly defining your desire. Be as specific as possible about what you want to manifest. The clearer your vision, the easier it is to focus your energy and intentions. You can write it down, document your desire. The second step is to cultivate the feeling of the wish fulfilled. Immerse yourself in the feeling of already having achieved your desire. The emotional alignment is crucial for manifestation. The third step is to reprogram your subconscious mind. Develop affirmations that support your desire. Repeat these affirmations daily to imprint your goal on your subconscious mind. The fourth step is to reduce the importance and detach from the outcome. Reduce the perceived importance of your desire to minimize excess potential and resistance. Practice detachment by letting go of the need to control the outcome. Don't worry about how it's going to happen. Just let it happen. The fifth and final step is to simply navigate pendulums and maintain energy levels. Recognize external influences that try to sway your thoughts and emotions away from the reality that you want. Then consciously choose to detach from these pendulums. So you can create a daily practice or ritual. Begin each day by setting an intention that aligns with your reality that you want to create. Cultivate gratitude for what you already have in the fulfillment of your desires. And then reflect in the evening. Visualize at least a little bit every day your reality that you want to create. By following these practical steps and incorporating daily practices and rituals into your routine, you create a fertile ground for your desires to manifest. Remember, the key to successful manifestation lies in the alignment of your thoughts, emotions, and actions, coupled with trust in the natural flow of the universe. Now, there are many examples of people that have manifested and created their reality. That's where the proof is in the pudding. You can find these examples in the many books that I've read to you. But just to give you a couple that come to mind, I knew someone that was paralyzed and was told they would never recover. And despite this, they held a deep desire to heal and live a vibrant, healthy life. They practice heart-brain coherence and maintain a state of positive expectation and well-being, raising their frequency and visualizing a healthy and active life, and employed affirmations to support their body's innate healing ability. A strong emotional connection to the desired outcome, consistent practice of visualizing and maintaining high energy levels, began this healing process, and the result was that they were healed and were able to walk again. I knew a couple that dreamed of owning a home that seemed beyond their financial reach. They desired a space that felt like a true reflection of their personalities and aspirations. When they came to me, I admit even I had doubts that they would ever be able to live in the mansion that they had dreamed of. They created a detailed vision board that included images of their dream home, and they practiced gratitude for their current living situation, accepting where they were at now, while feeling the joy of living in their dream home, and detached from the how and when, trusting the universe to deliver. With clarity of vision, emotional investment in their desired outcome, and gratitude, they ended up in the exact home of their dreams. This is just a couple of examples. I myself overcame an incredible loss in my business and manifested an entirely different business. I have experienced reality shifts using the techniques that I'm talking about hundreds of times. And I always sort of don't like to give details about the stories of how I've been able to do it because I don't want to take away the power of it. And there's some part of me that says, if I tell someone about how this happened, maybe it'll all fall apart. But it is magic and powerful, and I promise you that if you utilize these techniques, you will see a change in your reality. Understand, we began by understanding the malleable nature of reality and the pivotal role that your perceptions, beliefs, and thoughts play in shaping it. The power of belief, the art of assuming the feeling of the wish fulfilled, and the strategic navigation to the space of variations offered by reality transurfing were explored in depth. We delved into the significance of mastering your inner dialogue, the invaluable guidance provided by your emotions, and the critical alignment between heart and mind. I have given you strategies to overcome resistance and navigate challenges that will happen along the way. The key to creating your reality lies in the continuous practice and refinement of these techniques. Your journey of creating your reality is unique and ever-evolving. It is a process that calls for experimentation, adaptation, and most importantly, a belief in your power to manifest your desires. So be clear about what you wish to manifest. Strengthen your belief in your ability to create your reality. Align your emotions with your desires. Integrate these practices into your daily routine and just be open to the universe's guidance and the myriad ways your desires can manifest. This journey is not just about achieving a specific outcome, but about discovering your innate power and the joy of creating your reality. It's a journey that transforms not only your external world, but also your inner self, leading to growth, fulfillment, and a deeper connection with the universe. Let this episode serve as a beacon to guide you towards the realization of your dreams and the creation of a life that reflects your deepest desires and highest aspirations. Your reality is yours to shape, and the journey is as magnificent as the destination. Embrace it with open arms, a willing heart, and the unshakable belief that anything you can imagine is within your reach. You can find all episodes of The Reality Revolution at therealityrevolution.com. Please do me a favor and put a like on this video. It really, really helps out my videos. And I would sure love it if you checked out my art. You can find it at www.newearth.art. And welcome to The Reality Revolution. Thank you.